This video will give you a quick overview of how to perform single and multiple trims in the trimming interface. First, select the clip you want to trim on the timeline and click Edit to open the editing panel. In the Video tab under the Tools section, click Trim to open the trimming interface. You can also click the scissor icon above the timeline as a shortcut to quickly open the trimming interface. The trimming panel has two modes, single trim and multi-trim. Let's start with how to use the single trim mode. First, move the playhead to the position where you want the trim to begin. Once you're there, click the mark in icon below or press the I key on your keyboard to set the starting point. Next, move the playhead to where you want the trim to end. Click the mark out icon or press the O key to set the end point and complete the selection. Aside from using the buttons, you can also drag the yellow markers on both sides of the timeline to quickly adjust the trim range. The blue area on the timeline represents the currently selected trim section. The panel on the right shows the duration of the trim section, along with the start and end time codes. You can also enter values directly for more precise adjustments. If you want to lock the clip duration, click the lock icon next to it. This allows you to move the entire trim section freely without changing its length. Next to the playback options, you'll find original and output buttons. Switching to original lets you preview the full clip. Choosing output will only play the selected trim section, making it easier to check your work. In multi-trim mode, you can mark multiple time ranges to quickly extract several clips from the same source. The process is similar to single trim. Set a start point and an end point to define a trim section. Repeat the steps to create multiple trim segments. These segments will appear in the panel on the right. If there are any clips you decide you don't need, select the clip first, then click the trash can icon below to delete them. The magnifying glass icons at the bottom let you zoom in or out on the timeline for more precise editing. You can also directly drag the blue box here to select the area you want to zoom in on. If you prefer to mark the sections you want to delete instead, first select the unwanted parts, then click the double arrow icon on the far right. This button will invert the selection. The marked areas will become the ones to delete, and the unmarked areas will be kept as blue trimmed segments. If your clip contains multiple scenes, you can use the scene detection feature to help with marking or initial trimming. After clicking the scene detection icon, PowerDirector will ask whether you want to automatically split the video into separate clips. If you choose no, it will mark each scene change with a red line on the timeline. If you choose yes, it will automatically split the video into multiple segments based on scene changes, making detailed editing easier later on. Once you're done, click Trim to apply the settings.